weren't having real conversations. You know, we were just hearing but not really listening, or, you know, just dealing with things on the surface level. I was seeing that there was a lack of, like, empathy and humanness, and I primarily saw it with a lot of the women that I interacted with my day-to-day job. And matter of fact, I'll give you some insight. So my job, Harlem United, sponsored this event, the initial event. And someone asked me, like, what's the correlation between working with Harlem United and, you know, because they're all about prevention and, you know, and care and all that other kind of stuff. And I'm just like, this is a new take on prevention, because prevention starts when you have self-esteem. When you value yourself in a certain way, you won't find yourself in certain risky behaviors. And I was noticing that with my clientele. And I was just like, I want to do something about it. I want to find a provocative, innovative way to elicit those emotions and really charge that conversation and say, like, okay, why are we doing sort of things? Yeah, you do it. Yeah, it's a pattern, but do you understand why you're doing it? And what became really evident is that a lot of women, and some men too, were just falling prey to the fact that there was a lack of self-esteem. And so I was like, you know what? Let's interject that self-love. And, you know, when you find things and you find the beauty in those things, you might then internalize that and see the beauty in you. And so that can come from a lot of different things. So with this movement, it's addressing all those things. So it's about empowerment, it's about self-love, it's about wellness, it's about humanness, it's about being attached to my other brother and sister, you know, like really understanding what our day-to-days involve and meeting yourself on a common ground. And so that really was like the real catalyst for what that is. And just learning how to use our voices again, because I was seeing that was nothing that we weren't using. Like, we didn't really know how to say what we were actually thinking. And why not push forward for that? What I want to see in the future is this. I want to see a room of people being inspired, talking about these hard conversations and what that means as far as our interpersonal relationships and how things can get better. You know, I don't want it to be like, oh, she had this event in October, oh, she had it in December, and then it falls by the wayside. You know, I want people to be inspired and want more. Because the more there's a want and the more there's a need, then we'll give that more. And so my vision is just for this to continue and continue and continue and see the evolution of us as a community. And that is Conversations.